trans racism is disgusting and it should be opposed for what it is. But to understand the man Tan, you've got to see him as someone who's broken in the head. If you see a weak man who is wounded and he's flailing about and he's kicking other people, you still try to help him. The guy is broken.
He needs a hug, man.
And he does. This isn't how you oppose Islamization. You oppose Islamization by pointing out the fallacies and incoherent ideology that is Islam. You oppose Islamization by offering something better. You don't oppose Islamization by just being stupidly offensive.
But the same time though, if you look at the condom, what he said, he wasn't being racist, he converted him. He wasn't saying that, but I just think that some of the stuff he's saying.
He said a lot of things about black.
And what happened is he's dividing the alleged allies that could protect him. Yeah. Now he's like a zebra going away from the herd. Yeah. Now the tiger's gonna go again.
I remember he watched this thing about the Tan prophecy, and he was talking about
Tan prophecy.
The Tan prophecy, the Star Trek thing, where he says Islamic terrorists killed a black marine. And he goes, where was Black Lives Matter on that? Well, actually, Black Lives Matter was on that. They were making points about why is this black man going off fighting in a war?
The best way to understand Tan is someone who is dealing with an emotional trauma.
Yeah, thank you.
He is a broken man, an injured man. And people that are cheering him on in his racist rhetoric are people cheering on a man who's drowning. You know, like, and I would encourage everyone who's part of the black community here at Speaker's Corner to just rise above it.
Yeah.
Rise above it. Be the better man. If you see a weak man who is wounded and he's flailing about and he's kicking other people, you still try to help him. The guy is broken.
He needs a hug, man.
And he does. He's traumatized from something in his past.
I don't know what happened to him.
And he's working it out. And all those people that are cheering him on and applauding him are applauding a man who's wounded to his own destruction. And that's not charity. Charity is when you see someone drowning, you try and rescue them.
Amen to that. Amen to that.
You know? Like, Tan's racism is disgusting and it should be opposed for what it is. But to understand the man Tan, you've got to see him as someone who's broken in the head. You know? And he does not deserve
entertainment.
He does not deserve anyone's attention. Ignore the man. Don't give him oxygen. Don't feed that fire of hatred that's burning inside him. Because that fire of hatred is just destroying him. It's not going to destroy any of you. You can use the N-word as many times as you like. At the end of the day, it's a word, guys. Rise above it. Don't bite. Don't give him the oxygen that he's looking for, because he's trying to find meaning to his life, and the way that he's making meaning to his life is by being a controversialist here. His ideology makes no sense. His worldview is incoherent. Just leave the guy. I don't know what you can do with someone that broke.
He went on like an hour just saying fuck everybody.
Yeah.
What was that? Exactly. When I asked him about his stance on Islam, he was kind of like, he didn't really have a stance. He goes, oh, like Ali Dawa, he was calm down. You have a debate with Lawrence Southern. And this is like, Ali Dawa kind of proved his point in that debate. And he goes like,
I'm not so sure, but fair enough. Everyone's got their own opinion. I think Ali Dawa's a bit of a clown myself. But the reality is, Tan does not deserve. Anyone who debates Tan is lowering themselves.
So when you say something,
yeah, Tan needs counselling. Doesn't need argument. And all these people that are cheering him on, you're running down a dead end. This isn't how you oppose Islamization. You oppose Islamization by pointing out the fallacies and incoherent ideology that is Islam. You oppose Islamization by offering something better. You don't oppose Islamization by just being stupidly offensive.
said though, wouldn't you? But that's
not that is not opposing anything. All you're doing is charging down a dead end. And when Tans ran out of fury and fire, what are you left with? Nothing. Commit yourself to a better cause. That's the way you beat Islam.
About the whole Muslim religion, about Muhammad.